to be here this morning on this auspicious occasion of the public service lecture since the very first one since I took the oath of office as the governor of Ekiti State for the second time. We were used to this in my first time in office when Sir Patrick Odubunmi Fanosile was our head of silence. And just as been indicated by the moderator, and then we witnessed or experienced the hiatus in which this went into the doldrums. And I think it's important that it's been brought back as part of the civil service transformation reforms taking place. It is clearly a milestone of the administration, and it has further shown that we are indeed walking the talk. I thank the leadership of the public service in Ekiti State for organizing a forum like this with a view to reawakening the consciousness of the public servants and put them on the right path of our much cherished ethical values, which were eroded by a system that failed to give credence to posterity. I am particularly impressed that this topic, restoring equity values, prospects for the public service, is chosen for this edition of a public service lecture. I hope we will go a long way to address the errors of the past and reshape the public service for the much needed effective and efficient service delivery. I have no doubt that the guest lecturer, Professor Akinyebode, who is an erudite scholar, will do justice to the topic, even beyond our expectation. He's a round peg in a round hole. Of course, he's an international scholar of repute. As an Ekiti ambassador, Professor Ebode has many feathers to his cap, and I must say that the public service is indeed very lucky to have him speak to us on this occasion. Dear workers, public service and the machinery of government is pivotal to the implementation of the policies and the agenda of any administration. You would recall that during my inauguration speech, I said that the state has gone through a wilderness of maladministration for 4 years. The public service was not isolated from the maladies that characterized that era. Our reputation as a people and a state was solid, and we became the butt of jokes due to the poor attitude to governance in our state. On October 16, 2018, when we came on board as a government, we quickly began steps in restoring our core values of Omoluabi and rescue the state before it is too late. We're all aware that many things went wrong and many things are in need of correction. I appreciate the support of all EkitiState for helping to begin the process of restoring our values and enhancing impact. As a responsible government, things can only get better for all of us in the state if we stick to our principle commitment to professionalism, to candor, and to efficient delivery of services to our people. Excellency, Right Honourable Speaker, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, public service is the engine room of government. I therefore hope to see a public service that is built on policies thrust of dignity, of respect, of professionalism, competence, character, commitment, loyalty, visionary leadership, and efficient service delivery. The appointment of the present head of state, Mr. Dibiazai, was a culmination of a process that exemplified all of these values. It was based on merit, and a committee was set up, chaired by the renowned Professor Ladipo Adamolekun, and very senior public servants who examined the 5 most senior permanent secretaries before arriving at the choice of the current head of service. And he has been working assiduously to ensure the functionality of the public service as against what was obtainable in the past when permanent secretaries were chosen with the dice and senior officials were appointed on the whim and caprices of Mr. Governor. I'm of the opinion that if we ensure that the process that we undertake in selecting our senior public servant is as important as the eventual product, efficient service delivery will definitely not be a problem. Then we can appoint people who can firmly but respectfully tell the number one servant of the state that what they've been asked to do is not in line with proper procedures of the administration. The mission of this administration clearly is to reclaim our land and to restore our values. And we don't see it just as a campaign slogan. It is a call to chart a new course of sustainable development for our state. And my vision for EkitiState is that it should become a place where people can thrive and live their lives in dignity. A place where workers do not labor in vain. And a state where we can all be proud of either at home or in the diaspora. It is certainly a state where no one should come to you as public servant and use the name of Mr. Governor or any senior government official to curry favor or inappropriate preferment in the name of being sent by Mr. Governor. I must emphasize this. We have just undertaken a process of recruitment of teachers into our primary schools. The approval that has just been given is for secondary schools. And in that process, I know that some untoward practices took place, including people using the name of Mr. Governor to appeal for their preferred candidates to be given preference in the examination and interview that took place. Of course, those involved in that and those responsible for that exercise, they've seen my red eye and they know my position on this particular issue. On no account should anybody, no matter how highly placed, come to you and say, Mr. Governor said this, without you and the civil servant. Saying to such a person, firmly but respectfully, I'm going to check with Mr. Governor what you have said. And I don't send notes to people. There is no civil servant who can say I've sent a note to him or her that please, the bearer is from me. It's not that I don't get pressure. I receive a lot of pressure from family, from friends to help one person or the other. But I do not believe it is in my place to do that because we have promised that this government is for all Ekiti people, not just for one political party or the other, on one community or the other. So I believe the civil service and our entire public service is very well placed to ensure that this is implemented to the letter. Our government is striving to achieve all these lofty objectives through the five cardinal pillars of this administration, namely good governance, knowledge economy, social investment, agriculture and rural development, and infrastructure and industrial development. This administration places a huge premium on the welfare and capacity development of our workers. The establishment of the Office of Capacity Development and Reforms was primarily meant to develop a robust and meaningful training policy for the state public service in line with the vision of the present administration to improve the productivity of workers in the state. I am aware that within the first few months of its establishment, over 900 officers, cutting across different categories and cadres of the public service, have been exposed to training opportunities at home and abroad. You would recall my promise to EkitiState workers that I would ensure payment of salaries as and when due. To the glory of God, we have not reneged on the promise, and you are all living witnesses to its fulfillment. It is my priority that our state public service is well motivated and provided with the right tools, training, and ambient environment to function optimally. My visit to the State Secretariat earlier this year was a reassurance to the state workforce that I have their interest at heart, and as government, we will continue to pay more attention to their well-being at all times. Let me state unequivocally, as I have said at different forums, that my administration is committed to the payment of minimum wage to workers. We have commenced the implementation with the junior officers, and everybody who is on levels 1 to 6 must have received their minimum wage as approved in the negotiation by the federal government in their October salary. Others would equally be paid as soon as the consequential adjustment template is received from the National Wages and Incomes Review Commission, and negotiations start at the state level with the State Public Service Joint Negotiating Council. We will try our best to ensure that all categories of workers are covered. But then, as they say, to whom much is given, much is also expected. Because the finances of the state have not improved. As a matter of fact, if you see what we earn now, it's lower than what we used to earn when we came in October 2018. But we do not want to lament and languish on account of inadequate resources. We took a job and we have to devise all the creativity and innovation available to us to deliver on the promises that we made to our people. I plead for your support, your patience, your understanding in ensuring that it's not just civil servants that get the benefits of government. We must deliver the broader dividends to the generality of our people. Otherwise, even the benefits you are enjoying will be threatened if the majority of our people are not happy with government. And as much as we're keen to enhance the productivity of existing workers with incentive, we are also focusing on recruiting new workers. And this is what has led to the ongoing recruitment of primary school teachers, as well as the commencement of the recruitment of secondary school teachers. And it will also interest you to know that we have commenced the process of recruiting into the core civil service. As efforts are ongoing to engage more competent hands to join the workforce and fill some of the existing vacancies in the civil service. I can assure you that the recruitment exercise shall be based on merit, and EkitiState shall be the better for it. Indeed, we're counting the blessings and gains of the past 1 year of our administration, and you will agree with me that we're already out of the dark tunnel into the glowing light of fast economic recovery and speedy value restoration that we envision. Of course, there are still many hills to climb, many issues, many sectors, many projects, and the expectations of the people continue to desire more urgent attention. But we will also continue to do our best to ensure that more dividends of democracy that will set the state on the path of prosperity, honor, and integrity get to the good people of our state. Though we're not where we ought to be, we're also not where we used to be. With the support of all and sundry, we shall take this state to its place of pride. On this note, I want to particularly thank the guest speaker, whom I have had to apologize to, because I don't want to experience imposition and detention. Those who are products of Christ will know what that means. The guest speaker is a very, very senior old boy of my school. I didn't even meet him in school, so the imposition will be more severe if I do not explain why I'm not going to sit through his lecture and listen to his words of wisdom. But I've had to do that. And in the course of his lecture, I may have to step out. But Mr. Deputy Governor is here, and he will take my place to take the lessons copiously and report to me afterward on the gems of advice coming from our guest speaker. Thank you for listening.